Hey, Assure Callers and Certified Installers. Today we'll be talking through some terms that are commonly used in our industry. Attenuation and attenuators, ohms and connectors. These are important to know in order to get the most from your signal booster system. But you probably clicked on this video because you already knew that. Or maybe you were just drawn in by my ridiculously good looks. Knowing the three terms we'll talk through today will serve you well in getting the best in-building cell coverage possible. Let's get started with attenuation, then we'll get into ohms and connectors. Shameless promotion, all SureCall customers with applications larger than 10,000 square feet that require multiple antennas have access to our free design configuration assistance program as well as IB Wave Design. In that, we take all of this into account and much more. There's a link in the description to learn more about our design services. So, the technical definition for attenuation is the reduction of the amplitude of a signal. This reduction in amplitude weakens the signal, and this should be accounted for in your system's design. Attenuation can either be circumstantial or intentional. For example, if one of your antennas is too strong and is improving the signal in a space that doesn't really need it, you can intentionally reduce the amount of area that antenna covers by using what's called an attenuator, which would attach to the antenna's cable run to lower the strength by anywhere from 5, 10, or 20 dB. You can actually even stack these together to create more attenuation. On the other hand, if there are a lot of internal walls in the office, as the signal travels through those walls, it'll naturally be attenuated by the drywall, metal, or concrete. Another thing that affects the signal strength in a signal booster system is the ohms rating of the cable that you use. Ohms describes how much resistance there is between two points in the cable. To compare, when you're working with cable like RG6, you're working with a cable that has 75 ohms of resistance, whereas with the 400 cable, like what typically comes in a SureCall booster kit for large buildings, you only have 50 ohms of resistance. In short, that means you can go twice the distance with 400 cable than you can with RG6 while maintaining the same signal at the end of the cable run. A logistical thing that comes up quite often are connectors. There are many different types of connectors, but let's keep it simple. Connectors come in two general varieties, male and female. When you connect male and female connectors together, you get a connected and working system. While there are many different types of connectors, they all fall within one of those two genders. N connectors, F connectors, FME, SMA, TNC, the list goes on and on. Simple answer, just make sure you're connecting the male of one type to the female of the same type and you'll be fine. N male to N female, FME male to FME female, TNC male to TNC female, well, you get the point. So wrapping it all up, be sure to account for attenuation, take into mind the ohms rating of your cable, use the right connectors, and when in doubt, request a free design service using the link below and we'll handle the whole design process for you. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and check out one of these videos for more information about similar topics.